Hello and welcome. Today I'm going to be talking to you about these LongFi GPS trackers from Invoxia. I was very curious to pick up these trackers, and there were two main reasons why I wanted to do so. One was that I picked up a brand new Chevy Colorado truck recently, and I wanted to keep tabs on it, both for emergency purposes, theft purposes, and of course just adding that overall peace of mind. There are various options out there on the market for that type of coverage, but unfortunately, those monthly plans are a bit high and more than I would want to spend. These trackers come in at a very low price point, especially for the subscription, and I'll get into that a little bit later. Point number two, which has to, of course, do with the subscription, is the fact that these trackers run on the Helium network. I've been mining Helium HNT rewards for a while now, and also an investor, so I'm very comfortable on that end. But when it came time to actually getting a device that worked on this IoT network, I was of course curious on as to how is this going to perform. Is it going to work? Is it going to work well? It's 3 months later now, and I've gathered a bunch of findings. And if you want to learn more and want to hear about these findings, keep watching. As I mentioned, these trackers work on the Helium network, which is a peer-to-peer network for IoT devices. People add, let's say, a little router or a little hotspot to their home, and they get rewarded with HNT cryptocurrency by providing that coverage for devices just like this tracker. And the great thing about it for the end user is that these subscriptions come in extremely low compared to other networks that are providing coverage. If you want to learn more about the Helium network, I have a few tutorial videos, and if you're interested in that, I will link them in the top right now, as well as in the description below. There really isn't much to this tracker itself. There is a micro USB charging port, and of course a cable that comes with it for you to be able to charge it. There is a small attached lanyard here that is a bit elastic, so that you have a little bit more retention. And there is a little button here, just indented. You can see if I go ahead and press it, that little light or indicator light comes on. And also by pressing the button and let's say holding it down for a few seconds, it'll completely reboot the GPS tracker. So if you are having any kind of issues, be sure to reboot it. And that's basically it for this tracker. It's super lightweight, barely noticed that you even have it in your pocket. I opted for picking up two of these GPS tracker devices, and I wanted one, as I previously mentioned, for my pickup truck, and I wanted the second one to keep with me, and I do a lot of hiking and a lot of rucking and walking around with my dog, and I wanted to be able to track the local network in my areas, miners that I have going on in this network, and be able to get information back from both the Helium network and, of course, these Invoxia GPS trackers. To send me the location of where this little GPS tracker is, whether it's in my truck or whether it's in my backpack, and I receive those notifications via alerts on my phone through the Invoxia app. Okay, so first off, we have to set it up, and that is easily done by downloading the Invoxia app, which works both on Apple and Android devices and is free. Once you download and install the app, you follow the simple setup directions that you'll see right there on your device's screen. Once you do unbox the tracker, you want to go ahead and connect it to the USB cable and charge it up. Not only will this begin to charge it, but it will also wake up your device and get it ready to be paired with the app, so that you can continue your setup process. As I mentioned, I opted for two of these devices. So when it came to the setup process, I went ahead and set up my first one, which was going to be in the pickup truck, and named that one Red. And the second one was added afterwards, and I named that one Coach. And that is intended to be in one of my backpacks as I'm walking or hiking around. There is a geofence option, and you can go ahead and configure that to whatever preference you want and set your area. And once the GPS goes outside of that area, you will receive a notification. Keep in mind that there are a lot of details and specifications when it comes to this little LongFi GPS tracker, and I'm not going to be able to go over all of them in this video, but I will list them in my blog post. So if you want to get all that information and more, as well as purchase links, be sure to head over to it. I will link that blog post in the description field below. Another feature that I find useful is with this GPS tracker, once it moves and even tilts, once again, you have the settings in your app to go ahead and set sensitivity and things like that, it will send you a notification. So just if somebody were to pick up my backpack and move it somewhere, I'm going to get a notification. If somebody moves my truck, even just when the truck starts from the vibration of the motor, I end up getting a notification. You can go ahead and disable that also in the app. Now, as far as the tracking, I have about 3 months worth of data, and let's get into a little bit of that. I am in the New Jersey, New York City area, so there are helium hotspots all over the place. So there was plenty of coverage and redundant coverage in my area when it came to testing these little devices. When it came time to placing this GPS tracker in my pickup truck, I tried various locations and they all seemed to test the same. So for me, the more convenient place and to keep this out of the way was in the glove box, and that's where I kept it ever since. As you can tell here, the GPS tracker did a good job of sending my locations every few minutes. There are various interval settings, but I had mine set to ping every 5 minutes. The shorter the intervals, the faster that your battery will deplete. At max setting, you can get about 6 months on a single charge from these little trackers. Now, there were times when the pings would take longer than 5 minutes, but on a whole, the trackers worked well. I did notice that when I traveled at faster speeds, not all the notifications and position locations were logged. I ended up heading to Chicago for a few days and ended up, incidentally, because the GPS unit was in my backpack and I grabbed the backpack, brought it with me, and ended up tracking a bunch of stuff in Chicago. And Chicago is obviously a big city and has a huge helium presence there. So it was, once again, pretty cool to see it tracking my movements as I walked around and did some sightseeing, as well as on a few Uber rides, where I just ended up jumping in the vehicle, and it ended up tracking those movements also. There are also times when there is quite a bit of lag when it comes to receiving alerts. But keep in mind that I feel this has to do with the Helium network itself. As they continue to improve and speed things up, so will the performance of these IoT devices, including these GPS trackers. As a fan of the Helium network and somebody that's been following it very closely for the last few months, it was pretty cool seeing the miners get data credits for the coverage that I was providing from my miners. It's one thing to know what the Helium network can do, but it's pretty cool to actually see it live in front of you. There is also a feature that if you press the button on the tracker itself, it will send a notification to the app, to your phone, alerting you that the button has been pressed. While using the app, you're using a lot of Google features, so it's pretty cool that you can integrate that and check out more of a real street view type views. And there's a lot of different options there, including directions that you can click on that last location and have Google get you there. There have already been 2 firmware updates on these GPS trackers from Invoxia, so that's pretty cool. At least we know that Invoxia is keeping up with everything and making sure that we are getting the best experience and continuing to develop that experience. The great selling point of the Helium network is that they manage to provide coverage while keeping costs extremely low. Since they are using Helium's LongFi network, the subscription fee is minimal. You actually get 3 full years of Helium network coverage bundled just by the initial purchase of this device. And on top of that, after those 3 years are done and over with, the yearly subscription is $19.99. That's it, $19.99 for the year. Now that's pretty amazing. Getting into detail with these little Invoxia devices and getting into more depth with the Helium network from a different perspective, the only thing that I could say is the future really looks bright for Helium. There is still a great deal of room for improvement, but the network is getting bigger and stronger every day. And these devices, as well as the other IoT devices on the Helium network, will just continue to perform better and better as these upgrades get implemented. So bottom line, if you want a GPS tracker for your vehicle, bike, briefcase, backpack, pet, child, or 100 other applications, definitely take a look at these by Invoxia. They work well, they're inexpensive, and perform better with each passing day.